Is that why you came here? Just to borrow something?
Well, it was an excuse.
The great Winston Churchill.
It's a good picture of Churchill.
He's so good. Tiddler.
Good guy. A couple things.
We have some guests here.
Hey.
And... Yeah, I'm Casey Ross, one of the owners of Axe and the Oak Distillery.
I'm Ryan Toast, I'm the operations manager.
Hey guys.
I'm Nick Healy, I do sales and distribution.
JC Jackson, one of the owners.
Cool, thanks for coming in.
You better.
You're just a distiller down in Colorado Springs. If you see the Axe and the Oak, that's these guys. We've been here for a few years. And Casey came up and toured last year and wanted to bring his whole team up. They're kind of primed for growth and wanted to apply some of what we're doing here. So.
Cool.
They're cracking their skulls open and having fun.
Well, good. Thanks for coming up, guys.
Yeah,
thanks for having us.
Who needs help where? Does anyone need help where you are?
Are we getting anything done? It's a little bit slower today.
Does anybody know Andrea? Or who doesn't know Andrea? She is like everything to me, just below my wife and daughters. She worked here how many years?
Total of maybe eight.
Yeah, and we lived together over at Grey Rock Commons, also known as the what?
The village of the Damned.
Right? Chico Housing Community.
Beware so, the stare.
Yeah, so she was anchor Beware here for a long time in Zion. So I don't know if you missed her.
You want to ask
these? Sure. Card for Amy. Amy's grandfather passed away last week. So if you want to put a note in there, it'll just sit out here, and then Dallas will be the point person on that.
So these will be in the break room. If everyone could sign it, write a little something. Grandfather passed on Saturday. They're pretty close. And then we're going to figure out something together as well. So please do that today.
Cool.
Little note about Trello. Things have been getting better. People have been using more and more. One thing that we kind of fell away from was putting due dates on them. So that, again, is if you're using your phone, everything you need is basically behind that green square. So you can add a due date. That lets us know when you anticipate getting it done, and hopefully, unlike the old G slide thing.
I thought you said G string for a second there.
The old G string.
Yeah.
The G suite or wow G sheet standard. You won't just keep bumping it. Hopefully, this will mean a bit more. So it turns red when it's past due. It's actually the same coloring, and then so please get in the habit of doing that when you slide over to in progress. Add a due date so we can see what your intentions are. And then when you slide it to completed, which is another thing not everyone's been great about, you know, when you're done, actually slide it over. That will let us know when you finished it. Otherwise, we'll just assume it took you 3 months to screw something to the wall. Yeah.
So I'm there.
You want to mention card aging?
Wow.
And, card aging.
Yeah, and card aging, which you can see here. It's a little add-on. It shows how old the cards are. So, you know, maybe start at the oldest and work your way up.
It shows how long since the card's been, any of these been done on the card.
You can see it looks like old paper, kind of. Those are older ones.
Yeah.
The paper's deteriorating.
The card hasn't been touched, moved, or anything hasn't been done on it. In a week, it gets a little older. 2 weeks, even older. And then after 3 weeks, it starts to look ancient.
That's super cool. I'm going to tell you guys and gal what it is about this that's so cool for a guy like me who can barely focus enough to get to his car. It takes me about 3 attempts to get out of the building. It's simple, it's visual, and it feels manual. Have you ever used this program? Okay, it's a collaborative project management software, and you can put your finger on it with the eye type of stuff and just slide it over. It feels like sticky notes almost. And so, just like always, I'm the kid at the back of the class, so this guy's in the front of class, I was at the back of the class, so there's probably, I'm gonna guess, 60% of the people here are barely even using the app yet, and that's okay, we're trying to figure it out. Get your phone, and the one thing I'm really trying to do more than anything else is help them see waste, okay? And that is the fundamental tenet of what lean thinking is. It's a starting point. And it's really easy to know what waste is, which is if something sucks, okay, then underneath it is some sort of clutter or waste. You can't get it, you can't find it, you did it wrong. And so just to tag stuff, start tagging stuff. I see this, it kind of sucks, and put your face on it. That's all I want right now. As a priming of the pump. And then we can get together, and we can say, hey, look, you know, Brad's got 7 things he walked by, and he identified them, they bug him. And then you begin that next phase, which is just, we're gonna focus on one thing that matters to the person who is bugged by that thing. That's the starting point. So this is really just a simple visual way to identify. Brad.
So what
when we do this, we're making these giant lists that 30 eyes are going to be looking over once in a while, maybe often.
Preferably not.
If we can just be a little more precise and concise and not too cutesy, a little more analytical on the titling of them so we can look down the list, know exactly what we're looking at.
Yes, and what we're going to do, the goal behind this is to get everybody in the organization, especially those people who are in leadership positions, to start using this tool. It's the most powerful thing we've come across. Steven's going, no shit, 3 or 4 years and counting. It's incredible for Steve. He runs all of our purchases in Europe. But the point of this is that it facilitates a real discussion about what actually is. So if Zane goes and tags 10 things, and he does one doing and 5 completed or whatever, all Zane does is sit down with, let's say he's doing a review with Dallas. He just taps search, and then everything else goes away. And that conversation is just about Zane's world. So you can go in and just tag stuff all day long, and then you just go, what was I working on? Tag it, zero it in, and you can just drag one thing to the top. It's the idea that you're focusing on one thing at a time, and in the in progress for any individual, you should never have more than 3. Okay, a couple dumb ones that are easy to execute, and then one maybe that's more complex. So when you're waiting on parts, as we often do, you can still go, man, I still want to get this thing hung up. There's no outline, right? We don't have 2 of these. So just think about that as you develop. I'm expecting it's going to take about, without exaggeration, no less than 90 days to get us kind of about 80% engaged.
And to speed that a little bit, going through the old, like Trello seems to have renaissances in the companies. People pick it up, put it down. The old Gemba boards, I'm sure many of you have seen, have just like 500,000 cards each. So one thing we want to avoid is creating data for the sake of creating it if we're not going to use it. So to Brad's point, and we'll dive into this more and more, like Greg said, it's going to take us a long time. So every other day, every week, we're going to focus on new things. But one thing to keep in mind, when you're creating a card, I get that what that's about. But if it's a problem that I can't identify, I'm a lot less likely to pick that up. I can have a conversation, which is what we need to do, but as a person, I'm not going to just grab that one. So yeah. Maybe you can actually identify the problem in the title, and then like we went over yesterday, open the card, and there's a description. You can say, expand a little bit more. Here's the problem. Maybe here's how it's affecting people. And then in the comments, you can actually suggest a solution. So maybe you already know how to fix it, you just don't have time, or perhaps you have no idea how to fix it, and you're just putting it out there. We can actually fully use the tool to facilitate those conversations and get things done much faster. We just put an extra 20 seconds into actually building the card.
Okay, so we're gonna go back, we're gonna simplify. All I want you to do is see waste, take a picture of it, put as concise a title on the problem, and add yourself as a member. That's step one. Just do that for a month, okay? And then you know what you saw, you have a picture, you know what the problem was, and then when you decide this is the one that's bugging me, you can slide it into the in progress, but I do not want you to be composition majors. It's not going to get anything done, and you'll go, oh shit, I now got to write a little article. So this guy is academically light years beyond me and maybe a lot of people. Keep it stupid simple. That sucks. It bugs me. Take a picture, tag it. It could be a process. Man, why am I doing this? This is a janky process for taping edges. Identify it. It's a process improvement. But the idea is you can just tag it, let your brain rest. You put it in a bucket, and then you go back to that bucket and say, I really want to fix that. I need some help. Bring in Dallas, bring in 2P. But try to not get overwhelmed with too much information. So maybe your eyes are following him, but part of me goes, my head's full. So it's not to discount you, but again, I was at the back of the class. I was the D student. Let's keep it simple, visual, and manual.
Yeah.
So to the extent that you can join that party, join it.
Just to clarify, if you are going to be the one solving the problem and you know what's in your head, no need to put it out there.
It's your world, dude.
But if you don't know how to solve the problem, maybe put a little bit of an explanation. So if someone's looking for something to do.
Yeah, the idea is that I can't go 20 feet without finding 2 things that look for me. I'm going crazy. I just want you guys to get a little crazy. I go over to Arizona, I go, what do you guys see? What do you think I'm thinking? It's like, oh, I don't know. Right? Start looking around. And that's what really, I'm just trying to do that, Patrick. And the idea is that we shouldn't have somebody, that isn't being coached in a vacuum. That's the goal. So it's the idea of just slowly learning to see. I remember, Stephen, you were here for a while, and I know we're biting this on. You said it took a while for you to get your wire tripped, didn't it? It wasn't like that bada boom?
A little bit, being new, you weren't too sure what was supposed to bug you? What's wrong? What's out of place? I mean, you have to kind of learn the place a little bit before you start seeing what's out of place, what's not.
Yeah.
There's some basics, you know, get it off the floor.
Yep.
Or, you know, all those, but...
But the idea is there's different people operate at different levels of engagement. I run at a perpetually irritated state. Everything bugs the shit out of me. There's nothing that doesn't bug me. And then other people are more chill, like Steve and Alex, you're a peaceful dude. It's like, man, this guy's chill. I want some of that. But, you know, the other thing is there are things maybe you can't find. It's as simple as that. And that's all it has to be. Seth.
And just for the efficacy of the tool and the future state of it actually getting used and utilized and to avoid over-processing, please just make sure that the titles are good. That they have information. So if we're sorting it and prioritizing, we know how. Because we just make sure the titles are nice, to Brad's point. Keep it simple. Get bugged. Keep the titles good.
You got it.
All righty. Dan, you're up.
Yeah. What up, guys?
Daniel Weiss.
I have no idea what order these are in.
I hope you can drive this thing.
Alright, so, hi, I'm Dan.
Hey, Dan.
So I was born and raised in Fort Collins. I'm 25 now. Actually, I was born in Denver. Fun fact, I was born a little bit over 2 months early. So I was actually born in Denver because PBH couldn't do any fun stuff.
Reiki.
That's my girlfriend. That's Danielle.
That's adorable.
That's one of the 14 ducks that we have had, and Storm has eaten. So we're waiting, we're waiting on Storm to kind of go in her gentle, merry way until we get more ducks. But we both love animals. We have 3 dogs, 2 cats, 2 different birds. We had 2 hamsters, and then 8 ducks at one time. So lots of fun stuff. There's Storm. We like to go shooting a lot. Anything to kind of go outside. Dirt bikes, camping, fishing, kind of anything in the outside.
That's cool. I just wondered, this portrait of this incredibly beautiful woman, would you look at this audience, would you just let them know right now she's not your sister?
She's not my sister.
Okay.
Soon to be.
Okay.
Something. Every year we go up camping with my family, very far into the mountains. This is up near Medicine Bow National Forest, so this is actually the backside of Colorado.
Nice.
But you have to take like a 8 to 10 mile different trail to get up there and go across snowbanks and boulders and all sorts of fun stuff just to get over there. But there's a bunch of ponds and stuff, so we do that every year with my family for about 5 days around 4th of July.
Nice.
Danielle just got a bike, so that's new for her. This is Bella. That's my youngest dog. First time I got her, she decided to go to soccer with me and then fell asleep in the back on the soccer ball. So that's a picture of her. I actually coach soccer for going on 4 years now. I've played at CSU Pueblo D2 and played since I was 4. So I'm trying to get back, I guess.
Nice.
And my boys just won their tournament last weekend. And then that's the other dog that's a dork. That's Kira. This is my old truck that's now gone. Sorry, Steven. Now I have a Jeep. And that's Danielle's Jeep that we now have. So off-roading is a big part of what we do. I've been on 2 wheels since I was about that age, so I grew up on the racetrack. My dad used to race super sport bikes. My mom raced super sport bikes. Grew up on the racetrack, grew up around anything with a motor and 2 wheels.
Nice.
That's cool. Great. I can tell you my parents are pretty badass.
They're so badass.
That's what I grew up doing, and that's how I became who I am. There we go.
Thanks, Dan.
Nice, Dan.
Yeah, who's going next?
Who's going next?
Who hasn't gone?
Show of hands.
I'll be gone.
You've already gone.
Lori?
You've already gone.
Oh, I did. Thank you. It was horrible, yeah.
Lori hasn't gone yet.
All right. Lori, Andrea. Next? All right.
Andrea.
Yeah. I want to shout out Brandon and Steven for giving us Trello. They're the ones that introduced it and have kept it on life support. They've been using it diligently and properly for years, but as the company, you know, so thank you.
Like seeing ways, seeing Trello can take a long time.
Thanks for checking it out.
Yeah. What do you got?
Shout out to Tony, Seth, and Brad for our problem solving this morning.
You got it. We're good.
Someone's got it?
Yep.
Okay. Sorry, it was
where's B3?
He's loading the truck.
Want to shop B3 for going above and beyond. I'm going to call it mind-blowing service. Teamwork, if that's actually in there, but just staying late and getting stuff done yesterday and staying on it. And also, separately, I want to track Patrick Bailey for putting in a 12-hour day and going home tired and making stuff happen. So thank you for that, Patrick.
Bailey.
Yeah. I'm going to... What do we call that? I'm going to get one set of lists here. Getting on it and staying on it.
Any more? Very good.
Alrighty. Thank you.
You're easy.